welcome back to my channel. If you are new, babe, hit the subscribe button because we're gonna be besties. And if you're returning, you already know you're my besties. How are we, guys? As you can already tell by today's title, we're gonna be getting into a grocery haul as well as a meal prep with me. This meal prep is gonna be a little bit different because a lot of you guys have been mentioning in my comment section that you guys can't eat the same thing 5 to 6 days a week, which I totally get. So in today's meal prep video, I'm gonna be making 3 separate lunch or dinner options. You can rotate them between the two to see how it goes. It's gonna be very, very interesting because I've never had to do this before and I'm not sure I even bought enough stuff. Like, I didn't want to overbuy because it's just me, but we'll figure it out. I will also be including the calories and the macros for each of the meals that I prepared today, just so for that those who have been asking for them can have them. But remember, if you are triggered by calories and macros, please, girl, skip through it all. I'll put it at the very end of the clip where I prepare that specific meal. So if that's something that triggers you, girl, please just skip it because I don't want to stress you out. Okay, so let's jump into this grocery haul. Y'all are gonna have to forgive me today. My energy is way down because I got my booster shot the other day and it literally took your girl out. Like, all I did yesterday was sleep, and this morning I had to force myself, literally drag myself out of bed, and I have the worst headache right now, but just bear with me. All right, so to start the grocery haul, I got a bag of riced cauliflower, a head of iceberg lettuce, some red onion, some jalapenos, 1 pack of chicken, some yellow onions, some lean ground turkey, and some sliced mushrooms, tri-colored bell peppers, and some center cut bacon. Next, I have some Premier protein shakes. I got the caramel flavor and the chocolate flavor to spice it up. I also got some brown eggs. I also got some fat-free cheddar cheese and some frozen corn. We know that this wouldn't be a grocery haul without corn because I literally buy like bags of it. I literally have to have like 4 bags in the house. I also got these Power Crunch Pro Bars and the flavor s'mores. I absolutely love these. I gotta put y'all on. They're literally, literally so freaking good. This is them, love them. I obviously had to get some salad mix, so I got a box of spring mix. I got the individualized portions of the Oikos protein yogurt. I got a bag of waffle cut fries because, you know, Aunt Flo is coming in, or Rachel is coming in, and I've been craving fries. So I'm gonna have some of these later on today. Okay, I got some mild chunky salsa, some tomato ketchup. Tomato ketchup? Isn't all ketchup tomato? I don't know. I got a can of black beans, some minced garlic and water. And then I had to re-up on some spices, so I got some garlic powder and chili powder. Okay, I got some green chilies in a can, 3 avocados, and 3 lemons. Oh, I got some pencils for my students. And then I also got this Robert Irvine's Fit Crunch Bar in the peanut butter and jelly flavor because I really wanted to try that too, so I'll let you know how that is. This is everything that I got. Oh, I forgot to mention that I went to Walmart and got all of this with the exception of the corn because I forgot the corn, and on the way home there was a ShopRite. But everything I got was from Walmart, so very easily accessible, very affordable.
Better to have a short life that is full of what you like doing than a long life spent in a miserable way. Really in control of things, that is to say, in which the future is almost completely predictable. Thank you.
Okay, y'all, let's get into these turkey burgers. So I'm getting ready to add some diced jalapenos, some red onion, and a mixture of red, yellow, and orange bell pepper. These are what I had on hand, but feel free to use whatever kind you like and whatever veggies you like in general. Now to season, I'm gonna add some olive oil and then my basic seasoning, which is some onion flakes, cayenne pepper, onion powder, garlic powder, and salt. Now to form my turkey burgers, I weighed out 190 grams of my mixture. Again, everything will be described down below in the description box. I'm trying to track my calories and macros these days, so I scooped out 190 grams, I rolled it into a ball, and then I formed patties. My mixture made about 6 patties. Now I'm going to caramelize my onions, and baby, let me just tell you, this was the longest 55-minute process of my entire life. I'm going to season my onions with a little bit of pink Himalayan sea salt, followed by some garlic and onion powder, and then top it off with some chili powder to kind of go with the theme and to give the onions some nice color as well. I cook these onions low and slow by putting them on the lowest heating setting on my stove. That way they didn't burn and they evenly cooked. If I felt like the pan was getting a little too hot or bottom of the pan was getting too dry, I added a little bit of water just to moisten it up, and it actually helped the onions sweat a little bit. Okay, here is how I plan to serve my turkey burgers throughout the week. I'll just wrap it in iceberg lettuce and top it with the fresh tomato. I'll probably put some mustard on it too because, you know, I love sauce, but this is what it's gonna look like. Now I'm on to seasoning my chicken. You already know I don't measure out any seasonings. We season with love over here. I'm going to start off by seasoning with my citrusy garlic from Trader Joe's, a little bit of cayenne pepper, some chili powder, onion and garlic powder, and some lemon juice. And then I'm going to toss it and throw everything into the air fryer because, baby, who's going to be over here slaving over this hot stove cooking chicken? Not me. So everything's going in the air fryer. I cooked the chicken at 380 degrees for 20 minutes. I definitely will say that the chicken was a little bit more dry, so maybe next time I won't take this little shortcut, but your girl was absolutely over it. Like, by this time I'd already be cooking for like 3 hours. I just wasn't here for it. I wasn't here for it.
Thank you. have chicken bacon avocado salad without the bacon and the avocado. So I added a quarter of an avocado and two slices of center cut bacon, and then I'll just toss it with whatever dressing I have on hand. But this is how I will serve it up for the rest of the week. Now on to our last recipe for today. So I'm making these Mexican taco bowls, and I'm starting with 24 ounces of ground turkey, lean ground turkey, and I'm seasoning it with some garlic, some red onion. I wish I had the yellow onion, but I used it all for my caramelized onion, so we had to go with the red onion. It was kind of giving a weird look, but it tasted fine. So I'm gonna just saute that until most of the pink is gone from out of the turkey. No worries, we're cooking the turkey until there is no more pink, girl. We don't eat pink meat. Next, I'm going to season it with some chili powder, some garlic and onion powder, cumin, cayenne, and a can of green chilies. Eventually, you're going to see that I'm going to add about a third of a cup of salsa in there to give it a nice sauce, and then I'm just going to stir it and simmer it down until it's thick enough. Mixture is done. I set it off to the side, and now I'm going to hit the veggie portion of this dish. So I have one bag of cauliflower rice. I'm going to add some mixed bell peppers, again with the red, orange, and yellow. I'm also going to add 15 ounces of frozen corn, followed by one can of black beans rinsed and drained, and then a little bit of jalapeno, nothing too crazy. I'm going to stir it around, let it heat up a little bit, and then I'm going to season with a little bit of salt, garlic and onion powder, chili powder, and then off camera I tasted it and it needed just a little bit of cumin, so I added that off camera. I'm gonna let that sit on the stove without touching it for about 6 minutes so that the bottom of the vegetables get a little bit of a crust on them, and then I'm gonna assemble.
Full of what you like doing than a long life spent in a miserable way. That is to say, in which the future is almost completely predictable. Thank you.
right, everyone. So here are the 3 days worth of turkey burgers. I have 4 days worth of the taco bowl meal prep and then 3 days worth of the salads. I made 10 meals in total, so I'll be able to mix up which days I have what. I have a little bit left over, so if I run out of anything or need more of something, I have some still left over in the fridge. Like I said before, I really wasn't sure how much I needed to buy in order to prepare the food because I wasn't sure how many meals I was going to be making anyway, but this is what it is. This definitely took a lot longer than my usual meal prep. I mean, it usually takes long when I film kind of, but making an additional meal actually prolonged the process, but also I think that most of them were like time consuming. So like, I don't think that this would naturally take that long, but this is what it was for today. But here is everything. You've already seen previously how I will be serving the turkey burgers as well as dressing up the taco bowl, and then how I'll be adding the bacon and avocado to the salad. So this is everything that I have.
Okay guys, I'm officially done meal prepping for the day. It is like 8 hours later, and no, it did not take me 8 hours to cook it, but I was having lots of technical difficulties, which resulted in this being an all day process. This never happens, but I really want to give kudos to those people who can meal prep 3 to 4 meals like throughout the week, because honestly, it was so challenging for me. I'm going to challenge myself from now on to rotate 2 to 3 meals throughout the week for lunches and dinners, because a lot of you guys in my comments have been mentioning that you guys aren't creatures of habit, so it's a little bit hard for you guys to follow with just the 1 or 2 recipes that I do in my videos. But I really hope that this was helpful. I hope that you're able to take something away, whether it's just the recipes, the macros, or just the motivation to get up and meal prep, because baby, we know it is not easy. Please be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and share. And also be sure to put on your post notifications. That way you can be notified every single time your girl drops a new video. And until next time, I'll see you on my next.